Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the clinical case study about the faults that we done during the blood sample collection. Okay, the faults that we done during blood sample collection. A 38-year-old female went to the pathologist for routine blood examination. The pathologist asked the technician to collect the blood of the lady. While attempting to collect the blood sample from the median cubital vein, the technician noticed that the blood in the syringe is bright red. Okay, he immediately withdrew the needle. In second attempt, he inserted the needle slightly medial to the previous puncture. The lady felt sharp pain, which is radiated to the lateral three digits. Okay. See once again this, guys. A 38-year-old female went to the pathologist for routine blood examination. The pathologist asked the technician to collect the blood sample of the lady. While attempting to collect the blood sample from the median cubital vein, the technician noticed that the blood in the syringe is bright red. He immediately withdrew the needle. In second attempt, he inserted the needle slightly medial to the previous puncture. The lady felt sharp pain, which is radiated to the lateral three digits. Okay, the pain radiated to the lateral three digits. Next, coming to the questions. What is median cubital vein? Okay. What is median cubital vein? The what that we see here. The technician want to draw the blood from the median cubital vein. See here. Attempting to collect the blood sample from median cubital vein. It is a median cubital vein is a communicating vein in front of the elbow between the cephalic and basilic vein. Median cubital vein is a communicating vein in front of the elbow between the cephalic and basilic vein. See this figure. This is the cephalic vein. This is the elbow region. Okay guys, this is the elbow region. This is the cephalic vein. This is the basilic vein. The vein that connects the cephalic and basilic vein is a communicating vein, and that is median cubital vein. Okay, median vein of the forearm. And next, second question. Name the facial structure which separates median cubital vein from brachial artery and median nerve. Name the facial structure which separates median cubital vein from brachial artery and median nerve, and that is bicipital aponeurosis. Bicipital aponeurosis separates the median cubital vein from brachial artery and median nerve. Next, mention the cause of sharp pain that radiated to lateral three thought digits. Mention the cause of sharp pain that radiated to lateral three thought digits, three and half digits. That is due to the median nerve injury. See here, what the technician done. In second attempt, he inserted the needle slightly medial to the previous puncture. Okay, that means previous puncture. This that has the bright red. The lady felt sharp pain, which is radiated to lateral three digits. Okay, this is due to the puncture of median nerve injury. And the last question, that is, what does the bright red blood in syringe indicate during collection of the blood sample from the median cubital vein? That is puncture of the brachial artery. Puncture of the brachial artery. Bright red blood in syringe indicator during collection of the blood sample from median cubital vein. This is about the clinical case study, the faults that we done during the blood collection. Okay, if you like my explanation, please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks guys.